Welcome back to Daytime. You know what, Jason? Mm-hmm. Breaking up is hard to do.
It is. You know what? Are you trying to tell me something?
So is making up, though.
That's true.
Yeah, and here to break it all down for us, Paul Clark, the director of Mississauga Counseling. Thanks so much for coming back. Now, I mean, lying, I think, is a big thing when it comes to breaking up mm-hmm. with somebody. You kind of want to let them down in a more gentle way mm-hmm. at some point. Yeah. What's the most appropriate time to actually lie?
Well, if there is such a thing as an appropriate time to lie, yeah, it's kind of like, I would say that avoid lying if at all possible. You know, if you absolutely have to, if you think that the truth is going to absolutely devastate them. But generally speaking, you know, first of all, most of the lies are cliches. You know, it's not you, it's me.
Oh, yeah.
You know, but particularly, also the thing is, you know, I don't know what kind of lie you're talking about, but if you're saying, you know, I can't because my father is sick or I'm moving to another country, you know, they're going to find out sooner or later. It's also, lying is not recommended because ultimately, you're not doing them any favors.
Right.
You know, it's much more helpful to them to find out, for you to be honest with them and say, look, this is why it didn't work out, and, you know, I'm sorry, we did our best, but...
Can't the truth make the breakup that much worse, though?
Well, okay, you don't want to get into too many specifics here, okay? Mm-hmm. You don't want to say, you know, get into talking about their hygiene habits or...
You don't want to crush their ego,
you don't want to crush their ego. This is a time to be as compassionate as possible
mm-hmm. right.
and say, you know, and it may be very good reasons, like, you know, you said you weren't going to lie to me, and here I caught you on Thursday again lying to me, and I can't live like this. So as much as possible, try to be succinct, honest, tell them the truth, but don't go into the details of, you know, actually I thought you were bad in bed. You don't want to become mm-hmm. vindictive in terms of...
Okay, but what if they ask you, face to face, looking you right into the eyes and saying, well, what if I actually am bad in bed, or where did I go wrong? Can you be honest with them then?
I'd say within reason. Again, it's, you know, as compassionately as you can. You might want to tell them, you know, that it's a lot of things, but yeah, maybe that wasn't what I hoped it would be. Maybe that, you know, I wished you'd picked up your stuff on the floor mm-hmm. once in a while. But avoid, you know, even if they beg you and say, you know, tell me what I did wrong, because that's sort of where they're headed is, tell me what I did wrong, I can change.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Yeah, like what if they get angry about it?
Yeah.
Well, that happens all the time. And so you have to, don't react too strongly to expect tears, expect anger. And so don't get caught up in that. Don't, you know, say, well, you don't want this to end bitterly. So mm-hmm. you have to be sort of calm and anticipate this and expect a certain amount of resentment and anger.
This is not speaking from personal experience or anything, but a lot of men can come off as really cold-hearted when they're breaking up with their counterparts.
Oh, can they?
They can. Yeah. I think they absolutely can. So can they come off as maybe a little standoffish and maybe irrational if they're not being honest with that other person?
They can, I would say, and, you know, as a general statement, men tend not to be as sensitive about relationships and emotions as women are, and they can be a little bit insensitive in terms of, you know, well, yeah, this just isn't working out, and and occasionally they will end things very abruptly without a lot of explanation. But it goes both ways. Honestly, women can be just as insensitive every relationship is different. So mm-hmm. it's hard to sort of make a blanket statement and say all men are insensitive. But as a general policy, you know, when you see relationships, when you talk to couples in relationships, almost without exception, the woman will talk about our relationship and what we have together and, you know, if it's a family, our kids. The man tends to talk about me. You know, like what I wasn't getting enough out of this relationship. That's difficult. I didn't realize that when I got into this job, that mm-hmm. you know, how often it really is, you know, the woman working very hard on the relationship and the man sort of doing whatever he feels comfortable doing.
So what happens if you're the one being dumped? I mean, that's a sort of changing the tables around a little bit.
So, yeah, so there's some don'ts, definitely. If you're being dumped, resist the temptation to call right back. I mean, and I would say, if anything, it tends to be more with women than with men. You know, just to call, I just want to see how he's doing, and I just want to be sure he's absolutely sure about this. Resist that temptation. Take some time away.